Respected Comrade Hemlata, President of CITU, Comrade Tapansen, General Secretary of CITU, and the office bearers of CITU, office bearers of Tamil Nadu CITU, all the colleagues from the Central Trade Unions, my dear trade union leaders, and all respected veteran trade union leaders who are sitting here. At the outset, I bring greetings from the sisters all over India who are the poorest in the working class. And I represent that working class who represents the informal sector and the women and who have been deprived of their rights as workers. I congratulate CITU at their 16th national conference to bring together trade union leaders from all over the country to the southern part of the country at the time where the country is witnessing great phases of protest, where people are on the streets, people are raising their voices all together against all the draconian changes that our government is coming to force on us. And I think always the workers have been in the forefront of that struggle. As all my former speakers have mentioned, the country has witnessed just 2 weeks before a great struggle where more than 25 crores of workers, and majority of whom from the informal sector, from the unorganized sector of this country, have come out with a voice against the anti-labor policies of the government. And we are sure the workers in this country is united. That is what we see in this unity, which is proclaimed at each point of trade union gatherings. We stand, or we meet, and we have all these uncertainties and all these threats and all the struggles, I think, against our identities, against our class, against our citizenship. All these activities are coming together at this time, and I think most unexpected people are leading the struggles in this country. And that is the beauty of the struggles that is happening in all the anti-CAA protests happening in the country. We have seen in Shaheen Bagh what is happening. Women who are mothers, women who are informal sector workers, women who struggle for their livelihood, people who migrate from the rural areas to the urban areas, they are on the street 24 hours. None of Modi's police can threaten them at any point. That is their will. And we have seen that. We have seen the strength of the students of this country at this age of neoliberalism. The deepest breath of neoliberalism, we always thought we are having a new generation which has no interest in what is happening in this world. They are cyber children. They are not having any kind of sensitivity to the common struggles of the people. But the students in this country have proved that they have their identity, they have their voices, they have their strength, they have their unity. The workers in the country also has shown that this is the unity that we have to show. The farmers in the country has shown that this is the unity we have to show. This is the strength we have to show in front of the fascist forces that is going to suppress us in many ways. All the problems that we face have been shared by our respected trade union leaders. Actually, it is a second freedom struggle for our country. It is the time where majority of the people in this country are jobless. Majority of the country of these people are denied of their livelihood. Majority of the country, people in this country are denied of their land, denied of their houses, denied of their security. This is the time where the students in this country are facing, the youths in this country are facing employment at its top. This country has never witnessed such kind of economic slowdowns and unemployment where we are all looking at what is going to happen next. Before 15 years or before 20 years, maybe during the late 80s and late and early 90s, we used, when we started talking about shift in the structural policies of the government, we never thought this is going to happen. Let us see when the new data on labor and employment come, the informal sector in this country is going to exceed 97%. And the organized sector is only going to be represented with 3%. Workers in the formal sector have become informal, unorganized. We never thought this is going to happen to us. People who enjoyed all the benefits have been thrown out of their jobs because of the change in policies. How many people have thrown out of the banks because of the mergers of the banks? We never thought this will happen to this country. The nationalization and all the reforms that had happened has given us assurance that we will be safe. But none of us are safe. That is the situation of the country. And I think the labor situation has completely changed. We are facing a government having no concerns about the labor. And we know the labor ministry is the weakest ministry in this country. We don't have a cabinet minister for labor. We have only a state minister who can rarely look at the issues of workers, working class in this country. How can it happen? With the livelihood, with the production, with the GDP sustained by the poor working class of this country, and the government having no concern to the labor class in this country, the working class in this country. We know the kind of new labor that is emerging. We used to fight for a fixed employer, and we used to fight for a fixed employer-employee relationship where the employee, the worker, the labor had the access to ask their rights to the respective employers. But in India today, more than 60% of the workers are without an employer. There is no employer visible in production relationships. People in the lower tier are the majority. The entire working class for the globe is being supplied from the global south and majority from countries like India. And you have seen the disparities in wages, disparities in social security, and the kind of denial in all the dues, all the entitlements that the workers have been facing. When we go to women, when we talk about women who represent the majority of the informal sector, they are nowhere even in data also. If I say with the 50 crores established working population of the country, I will say there will be another 20 crores who are women who are undocumented as workers in this country. Women have no identity. Women still work for 25 rupees, 50 rupees, 75 rupees. They are in the margins, they are the outliers. What happened to our traditional sectors? When we talk about public sectors, traditional sectors is the most damaged sector in this country. We cannot speak of traditional sectors now. The country is not depending on traditional sectors anymore. Who keep the traditional sector surviving? What is happening to access to resources in this country? How many of the common poor have the access to resources, to land, to ocean, that is to sea, to forest? These were working class people's right to own this as community common resources. Now that has all been taken by Adanis and Ambanis, and displacements in long terms have happened from rural to urban, from towns to cities. And people are houseless. People are living in slums. The number of slums in this country is increasing. The number of people who are living in the streets are increasing. The number of people who are looking after work in the streets are increasing. This is the situation of this country. This is a very dangerous situation. What is going to happen in this country? When the trade union movements have asked for 700 rupees as the minimum wage of a day's work, the government has fixed us with 178 rupees per day. That is the result of the new labor law changes that is happening in this country. Who is going to affect? The majority, the informal, the poor, the women, people who have been thrown out from centralized working system. There are no more new industries, big industries being formed. All the industries have been scattered. All the jobs have been scattered to pieces. All the jobs have been transferred to homes. Each home is a working place now. And who is the employer? We are self-employed. Nobody. The state is not in protection of us. The employer is not in protection of us who is sitting like Ambani or Adani or whoever highest in the multinational linkage. How should we go? As trade union movements, I think especially all of us sitting here together to greet dear comrades of CI2. I think as somebody representing the poorest of the working class in this country, I think we should really rethink, we should really strategize the new phase of working class struggle. We should really consider the informal. We should really consider the self-employed. We should really consider the volunteers who are women who have been cheated by the government at any levels, like, you know, the ashas and Anganwadis and whoever it is. And more volunteerism is happening in this country. We should think about the migrant population who have been crossing the interstate borders, who are more than 100 million in this country. We should talk about the migrants who are crossing the country's border, especially in the context of CA and all, who are more than 15 million crossing the borders of this country. Can we organize them? Can we bring them together? We should think about majority of the women in the informal who are out of any of the resources and any of the livelihood systems and labor rights in this country. Let's think together. Let's organize together. Let's have a new phase of struggle. Let's include the maximum number of working class together in the streets of this country. Let's unite together with farmers. Let us unite with the students. Let us unite with the mothers against the anti-labor policies, anti-citizen policies, and anti-livelihood life policies of this government. Let us live together. Let's struggle together. Let's fight together. Long live working class struggles. Namaste.